Many board of directors make use of a consent agenda to save time at their meetings. A consent agenda groups the routine, procedural, and non-controversial items that need to be approved at a meeting. These items are presented to the board in a single motion. A consent agenda helps streamline meetings and allows the board to focus on substantive issues rather than on routine items. It works well because if a board member feels that a consent item requires more discussion or debate, he or she can simply request that the item be moved to the full agenda, where it can be seconded and discussed in full. If you want to adopt a consent agenda, the first thing you'll need to do is approve a motion to adopt the consent agenda for your meetings. Once approved, you'll want to develop a policy about what may and may not be included in the consent portion of the agenda. Here are some examples of items that could be included in your consent item section. Approval of board minutes. Correspondence requiring no action. Approval of contracts that fall within the association's policy guidelines. Dates of future meetings. Once adopted, you identify the items on your agenda which are routine, informational, or procedural, and include them in your agenda under the title Consent Items. Keep in mind that all motions must be dealt with in the main agenda, not with the consent items. When the pre-meeting package is sent to the board members, be sure to include all of the reports and backup materials for the consent items so that members can be prepared. At the start of the meeting, the chairperson asks if anyone wishes to remove an item from the consent portion of the agenda. A motion to accept the consent agenda is called, and the chairperson opens the floor for any quick points of clarification on the consent items before calling for the vote. Boards have freed up a significant amount of time at their meetings by using a consent agenda, resulting in more time spent on high-level strategic issues.